Good afternoon and welcome to the Market Wrap for Wednesday, the 17th of July. And it was yet another record-breaking session for the Aussie market today, which gained around 58 points, around 0.75%. And that means out of the past four sessions, the Aussie market has hit a fresh record high for three of those sessions. Now, the improvements are broadly stemming from optimism about an interest rate cut over in the US, the largest economy in the world. And thankfully, our local market has been able to reap some of those benefits. Not quite as much, though, considering the US market has reached almost 40 record highs since the start of this year and is up roughly three times as much as the Aussie market in the 2024 calendar year so far, but still impressive nonetheless. Across all the sectors today, all 11 improved. Real estate, tech and consumer staples stocks were some of the biggest gainers. Financials improved by almost 1% to yet another all-time high, which played a significant role in today's gains, while the mining and energy sectors both lifted, but they did underperform the rest of the market after commodity prices fell overnight. Oil was down steeply by 1.6% and iron ore fell by a third of 1%. Shares of surgical solutions company PolyNovo finished in the top spot after receiving a target price lift. Many of the gold stocks benefited from a 1.6% lift in the price of gold overnight to reach a record high, and that led the gold subsector 1.8% higher today to its highest level since November 2020. We saw the likes of Evolution Mining up 1.5%, Northern Star up 3.5%. Many of the others, including Gold Road, West African Resources and Bellevue Gold, up a similar amount, up between 2 and 3%. But BHP fell by close to 1% despite posting record iron ore production over the year. Uranium miners were also on the losers list, with Boss Energy and Deep Yellow ending as some of the biggest losers of the day. In fact, Deep Yellow was right at the top of the losers list, with the general weakness across many of the uranium miners seeming to overshadow Deep Yellow's positive corporate update today. The presentation talked up its strong production capability when they do reach that production stage, saying they could be the largest pure play uranium producer on the ASX. And DroneShield dropped another 9.5% today after falling over 22% in yesterday's session. The declines follow the release of an article to the media which said that DroneShield's share price may be overvalued. Now, looking over to currencies, the Aussie dollar has dipped a little bit to 67.3 US cents. It is roughly around where it was yesterday, but it has eased from those higher levels on the back of a stronger US dollar. Now, looking ahead to tonight, of course, we are in US reporting season, so we have many companies out with their reports, including Alcoa, Johnson & Johnson, United Airlines and a handful of others. And then tomorrow is the big day of the week locally, with Aussie job figures set to be released. That'll be out at 11:30 a.m. And we have some quarterlies coming out over the course of this week. Of course, we've already seen Rio and BHP. Tomorrow we'll have the likes of Evolution and Santos out with their quarterly updates. Have a lovely night.